Okay, so how is the current crisis in
Hmm.
Gaza affecting your work, and what are you doing to
Yes,
help
okay.
the refugees
Yes.
there?
Yes. UNRWA has a large operation in Gaza, the largest humanitarian agency working in Gaza.
Okay.
And then for health, we have 21 health centers. And for school, I think we have 200 plus schools. And then these are heavily affecting the current crisis. And the health part, which I know the best, up to the last week, almost always the 7 to 8 health centers out of 21 are closed. And we have 150,000, to be precise, 150,137 in 84 schools.
Wow.
So it's a huge number. And it's a
That's
very
very
contested.
high
Yeah.
number. A very high
Yes, it's
number.
very high.
Very difficult for you to cope with as an organization.
Yes, we planned for this, but it was totally overwhelming. If you see the increase of the refugee or displaced in the schools are drastically increasing. They just came or left the homes, and they stay in the classrooms or some of them on the schoolyard and sleeping. And we were trying to our best to provide the blankets and all the other things. And then actually today after this, I'm going to the airport in Jordan to receive the blankets. Others, it flew from Dubai,
From
and
Dubai,
then the
okay.
jumbo jet. Yeah,
So what part of the world, where have those blankets come from? Where are they? Okay, they're coming from Dubai, but who's donated them? Have they been donated?
there's a human. Yeah, there's a humanitarian hub in Dubai, which is many agencies are used. So there's a huge warehouse there. So we bring from there. So blankets are from many parts of
Actually,
the
I
world.
do know somebody who's in charge of that warehouse, in fact.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, from
Very good.
that, that's very
And then,
good. Yeah.
sure. So at this point of time, what I heard last week, now food, at the beginning, people complains about everything because
Of
it's just
course.
total outnumbered. Now that in many places, food are now basically available from our cold food and also the support from local agencies, local NGOs for the food. The one main problem in the shelter now is water and the hygiene. Because if you know that the Gaza, even before the crisis, there's a shortage of water, particularly clean drinking water, and also electricity. If you know that UN made an analysis last year, which is called Gaza 2020, and because of the extremely insufficient infrastructure, Gaza may become unliable or not a place to live by 2020. That was a report published by UN even before the current crisis. So you can imagine how the situation is now. And so they.
The crisis is at a, well, it's huge now. So how does this,
Yes.
the truce that's just come into place, this 12-hour truce, how does that help you as an agency? Does that
Yeah.
make a big
So,
difference?
anyway, that we have to provide a safe place for people. That's the most important thing because no place is safe in Gaza now. And then I don't know that I heard the news that they are going to do the ceasefire for 12 hours. Israel announced, but I don't know. It's in place on
It's
that.
in
But
place
nevertheless.
now,
Yeah,
but
good, excellent. But also, we have to wait for the other side's reaction.
exactly.
Nevertheless, that the location of our institutions are both sides, and so that they are not supposed to be bombed, although there was a shelling in a couple of schools last week, which is totally unacceptable. Nevertheless, it happened. But basically, they are staying in the schools. We provided the food. Again, the main problem, the water and hygiene. Like what I said, that infrastructure itself is extremely weak, and so that we can't cope with the water. So they are trying to buy water, bring in water, but to be honest, it is still not yet there, particularly in the big shelters. So that the toilet is not clean, to be honest, and there's no shower. And then so that is extremely, and Gaza is on the coast, and so it's extremely hot now. So it is totally unfavorable place for people to stay. I hope when the time comes soon that they can go back to their home. But nevertheless, that's the situation. The other part is hygiene. And then, although there's no, say, report of any outbreaks of anything yet, but, you know, if you're living under such conditions, we have to prepare that something like infectious diseases or some diarrhea could happen. So that is also our main concern now. And on top of this, without any security, without any stop of the war, the number of people moving to shelters could continue to increase. So that is also a major burden for us. So it's very much on the current situation.
So there's no way you can increase the number of shelters. More people have to be crammed into the existing shelters.
We have around 200 schools, so that it is possible to increase, but, you know, it's also depending on our preparation.
Yeah.
You can't simply open the school and go in. No, we have to prepare ourselves that once they go in, they can get the good services, at least minimum essential. But at the same time, in the very crowded areas, our shelter cannot accommodate all the needs. And unfortunately, last week, what I heard is that some people are staying nearby the shelter because they cannot go in. Because it's totally crowded, and so that's a very unfortunate situation. I'm very much concerned.
So, what would happen now if what would happen to your agency if you had to deal with more problems, more conflict on the West Bank?
West Bank is also. I'm very much concerned the West Bank because the situation is as equal. It's quite to say to my layman's English, it's quite bad.
Yeah,
and then that the crashes every night everywhere, and then people are extremely frustrated, tense. I would say Gaza is like hell, to be sorry mm-hmm. this expression.
Mm-hmm.
But the West Bank is boiling; it's extremely boiling. So that's a very much concern. So going back to Gaza,
What would happen if you had to? Would you ever be in a position of having to make a choice to give aid to Gaza or to the West Bank? Does it get to that position?
No. Then what we are doing to Gaza is to make appeal for more support to Gaza, and that is interesting. Beginning of the last week, we made an appeal for $60 million. And then after 3-4 days, we revised to adding another $55 million. So it's now $155 million. Because the first one is based on the situation in the last week and $60 million. But within a couple of days, then the conflict increased and the casualty increased and number of people displaced increased. So we have no choice but to increase an amount of appeal. So it's $115 million now. Mm-hmm. Majority are food and non-food items. Food for the shelters, non-food items like mattresses, blankets, and all the other things. And other than that, the medicines and the hygiene kit, all these kind of things. So without additional support, we cannot cope. And then I don't think that is great. That is a nice situation that we have to make choice. One disaster, other disaster, which one to choose. We really have to address both.